my name is Mafaza Sharfuddin, and this is my partner Sama Asia, and we are strongly for the statement nationalism was the major cause for World War II. Thank you.
We team B, and we stand strongly against this statement. Nationalism was the major cause for World War II.
We're team A, and we stand against the statement. Nationalism was the major cause of World War II.
Nationalism now is extreme patriotism, stating that one feels superior to another. When I hit Google to find out the causes of World War II, the only thing I found was Treaty of Versailles, Japanese expansion, fascism, appeasement, Hitler, Great Depression, imperialism.
Now let us dissect it one by one. The Treaty of Versailles caused the Germans to get angry because their country was treated as inferior and they felt that they were superior. Nationalism. The Japanese expansion, they thought they were bringing better technology into the world. They thought they were better than the rest of the countries. Nationalism. Fascism is the thought of putting nation above the individual. Again, nationalism. Appeasement is the countries wanted peace among themselves, but Italy and Germany felt that they should colonize people. And imperialism too means the colonization of people, meaning that they think that they have the military ability to take over the... Thank you.
So Team C spoke about Googling stuff and the meaning of nationalism, what it has come to. So if you Google nationalism, you'll actually know it's the feeling of patriotism for one's own country. And also they spoke about how the idea of country over a person. So we all know who started World War II. It was Hitler who invaded Poland. And when we think of Hitler, we don't think of Germany. We think of his ideology as a Nazi.
Okay, to add to the point made by Team B, nationalism is not just a feeling of patriotism. It is a feeling of patriotism in a very extreme way. So just because a person is nationalist or he follows nationalism, that doesn't mean that can create a world war, that can make soldiers risk their lives and fight for the country.
Okay, one of the major causes of the World War II was the Treaty of Versailles. Team A said that the Treaty of Versailles made Germany feel that they're inferior. Team C said that it made Germany feel inferior, but that's not the case. The Treaty of Versailles imposed huge war debts on Germany. Germany's economy was reduced to a low level, and Germany wanted to build up their economy, and it was not because they felt superior or inferior. So get your facts right.
We would like to begin this round by contradicting my friends in Team A. Yes, we do agree that the Treaty of Versailles had a huge impact on Germany. What we did not say that it felt inferior. We said that the world made them seem inferior. Thank you.
In contradiction to Team A and Team B again, over Googling the term nationalism. Now, nationalism is extreme patriotism. There are two different words, nationalism and patriotism, because nationalism always leads to violence. This extreme form of patriotism will lead to violence.
And speaking about Hitler, as Team B stated, the first thing you think about is Nazi ideologies, which is chauvinistic, saying that the Aryans, the true Germans were better than anybody else, which means we are better than them. Again, nationalism. Thank you.
Team C said that there are two words that they wanted to point out, nationalism and patriotism. I'd like to add a third word called aggressive nationalism, and that was what caused the World War.
So Team C spoke about Aryans as a race. So if Adolf Hitler was actually focused on nationalistic views, he would have focused on Germany as a whole and not exterminated Jews as he did, because he wanted to promote his individualistic ideology and protect Nazism as an ideology and not Germany as a whole.
To Team CL spoke about two words, nationalism and patriotism. So where does inferiority and superiority come into play in this statement? And adding to my point, the Japanese militarism. So when the Japanese had the power, that is when they wanted to take over the other nations. It wasn't nationalism that caused World War II.
Okay, another aspect was the economic unrest in the other countries like Germany and Italy. It was these countries which wanted to build up their economy, which wanted to recover from the economic effects of the First World War. So where does the topic of extreme patriotism come under economic policies?
And the third factor would be political unrest. And that is not nationalism which caused World War II. It was a political unrest among the countries that caused World War II. Thank you.
We would like to begin this round by talking about, as Team A and B have stated, about the other causes of World War II. See, we haven't said that nationalism is the only cause of World War II. It is certain that one thing cannot cause an entire world war. What we're saying is that nationalism is a major cause of World War II, because a lot of the causes can be linked to nationalism in the end.
Team A asks us, how is superiority and inferiority linked to nationalism? Extreme patriotism always makes you feel that your country is better than any other country. And this is how Germany too felt. So when they feel this extreme patriotism, they obviously want to show their superiority and make the others feel inferior about it.
So we would like to strongly say that nationalism was the major cause for World War II. Thank you.
So, assuming I'm the head of an extremely powerful country and I'm on the global forum fighting. Okay, so if I was nationalistic, would I back down on such a global level showing that I'm anti-national? But USSR backed down on its word and did not fight World War II after a certain point, showing that they weren't nationalistic in ideology and they were idealistic and not fighting for the power and colonization of other countries.
I'd like to point out that nationalism wasn't a major cause for World War II, it was anti-colonialism. The concept of nationalism arose from World War II, it wasn't a cause for nationalism. I'd also like to point out that the after effects of World War II that happened on Japan, the nuclear bombings on Japan, it was because of the nationalistic tendencies of Japan that made them rebuild from the roots.
And in contradiction to what Team C spoke about, you spoke about how one thing cannot be the cause of World War II. That is exactly what we are trying to tell. Nationalism wasn't the major cause of World War II. Those things like political unrest, economical unrest, that was the cause of World War II. And speaking about Germany wanted to expand, and that is the reason why the World War II began in the first place.
The immediate cause of the Second World War was Hitler's invasion of Poland. Hitler's main idea was the expansion of his country. He wanted to occupy the demilitarized land of Rhineland. And this is when the countries like US and UK imposed restrictions on them and declared war, because they didn't want them to expand. Where does nationalism come in expansion?
And then Italy gets involved. And then the savior of the world, the United States of America, gets involved. And voila, we have World War II in our hands. Thank you.
Last round. We would like to begin this round by answering my dear friends in Team A. Look, when a country decides that it wants to expand, it says that we have the capability, we have the military capability to overtake that country. What does that mean? You think your country is better at this than that country. What does that lead to? Nationalism.
Fascism, which was a major reason for nationalism, clearly states that a political philosophy, movement or regime that exalts nation above individual, a nation above individual. So this clearly states that nationalism was the reason people believed in it.
We would like to say that definitely colonialism came into play. The Great Depression came into play. All of these causes were there that led to the World War II. But in the end, majority of the causes can be led back to a nationalism like Mussolini, Hitler, and the Italian expansion. So we would like to rest our case by saying nationalism was the major cause of World War II.
Team C said that extreme patriotism was a cause for nationalism. And they also said that it meant that uplifting your own country and putting other countries down. Doesn't that prove a very individualistic ideology? But the fact that allies and axis blocks were formed proves otherwise.
They also spoke about how a nation comes above an individual. When you talk about dictatorship as a word, it always means that the ideology of that individual is greater than the ideology of the communities present in the country. And also saying that nationalism hasn't died down after World War II. Nationalism still exists in today's world. But the fact that the Third World War hasn't happened yet shows us that nationalism wasn't in itself a major cause for World War II. Thank you.
And in contradiction to Team A, no, Team C, you spoke about Hitler, that he was nationalist. So do you think that just because Hitler was nationalist, he would convince so many soldiers to just lay down their life for the Germans?
Okay, be it Germany who wanted to develop, be it Italy, or be it Japan who wanted to show their military power, or be it USA who wanted to show the whole world that they're saviors, Each country had their own personal benefit. Each country had their selfish and personal causes for the World War II, and it has nothing to do with aggressive nationalism, it has nothing to do with aggressive patriotism. Thank you.
Everybody wanted to be the king of the world. That is the main reason why World War II occurred. So we would like to conclude by saying that we strongly stand against the statement that nationalism was a major cause of World War II. Thank you.
Audience note.
Team A, you mentioned that nationalism is just having love for your country. How can that result in war?
We never mentioned that. We stated that it is extreme love for your country.
Yes.
Team B spoke about how it was just love for your country.
Yes. So upon that, when you have a nationalism, it often comes with a feeling of placing your country above the rest. Don't you think that is what results the war?
So just the feeling of placing your country over the rest wouldn't have allowed World War II to start, because each country had their own allies, so they had to consider them to be equals, because that is the only way World War II could have been started.
How expanding your country is love for your nation, that is not love for your nation, that is your selfish motives that comes into play.
In answer to that, we never stated that expansion was love for your nation. We said that expansion would be done because you believe that you have a military capability better than that of another country. So you believe that your country is better than the other country, and that's what leads to nationalism.